Amongst us is a very successful co-founder and CEO of Rewanta Lifestyle and Etaash Consultants, Mr. Sandip Pable, sir. Sandip, sir, is an HR leader with specialization in talent management, talent acquisition, and employee engagement. Sir, has rich global experience across diverse industries in various capacities with 500 Fortune organizations such as Deloitte, Tata Consultancy Services, and Electronic Data System. Sir has been Associate Vice President in Deloitte, and sir has also worked with Technip India Limited as India Talent Management and Recruitment Head as General Manager. He also achieved Top Employer Certification for Excellence in Employee Work Condition by Top Employers Institute as Top Employers of India. The list of sir's talent is endless. So therefore, now I request sir to enlighten students and share your wood of knowledge with us. Please, sir.
So when you talk about Volvo, what comes to your mind? Okay, so it's already written there. Huh? What comes to when you do M&M chocolates? Yeah. And Head and Shoulder? Yeah. So it's very clear. It's very simple, very crystal clear, saying that when I talk about Head and Shoulder, yeah, it talks about dandruff. Yeah. So they have identified their niche, and they are communicating on consistent basis to the audience, targeted audience, and they are able to successfully able to achieve it, and we can see that, right? So a brand is what brand does, yeah? And as an individual, these are companies who are selling products, but we are also individuals who are product, who are selling our services. And how do I brand myself is the topic is I'm going to discuss about it, which will solve most of our problem, because it's other way looking at it, other than saying that what exactly the industry is looking at and where is the gap. Yeah. So I'll ask myself saying that who am I and what I do, and how, what is a differentiated service I'm going to offer, and what is my brand is all about, so that my customer is able to pick me. So I have pick me value from the shelf. So marketing guys will be able to understand this terminology, pick me up, yeah? So that's where we're talking about. And I have done a certain amount of, you know, academics and theory to it, saying that what is the personal brand branding is all about, yeah? So a personal branding is a process where people and their careers are marked as brands. The concept suggests that the success comes from all self-packaging. An asset that pertains to a particular person or individual. So you can read it through what it's talking about. So the concept here is we are talking about self-packaging. Yeah? And it's Peter Drucker who started with, you have read through Kotler, yeah, talking about the entire, such a big thing about, you know, 5 P's about brand and product. So as an individual, when I'm talking about myself, yeah, so when I'm providing my own services, so I am the CEO. I'm the CEO of my me incorporation. Yeah. How I'm going to present myself, and I'm going to offer my services to my clients. Yeah. That's where it, you know, we are talking about, regardless of age, regardless of position, regardless of the business we are happen to be in, all of us, we need to understand an importance of branding. We are the CEO of our own me incorporation. Yeah. And you have large amount of control and influence over how you're going to present yourself to the world. Yeah. We'll talk about it in detail here. So, you know, I have one question, you know, talking about, so which toothpaste do you use? One at a time. So, I heard somebody saying Colgate. Pepsodent, okay. Close up, okay. Patanjali, okay. So we have got four or five of it. So do you think what Colgate does can Patanjali also do? So what is the functionality of toothpaste? So you, when you get up in the morning, you do cleaning of the teeth, right? So it brightens up and it looks white. That's all toothpaste does, right? So why do you pick up a Colgate or Patanjali or Pepsodent or Close Up, right? So it's a choice we need to make as an individual, saying that, do I need to be Colgate, Patanjali or Close Up? Yeah. So how many students do you think so we have 1,000 students here in this institute itself. Yeah. How many engineering students, how many management students, or how many graduates every year who are passing, who are getting into an employment arena? Lakhs and lakhs students who are graduating and getting into the employment zone, right? So out of this lakhs and lakhs student, one opportunity is there. So who would an employer will choose? Somebody who has created a brand for himself. Somebody who has differentiated services, differentiated himself from the crowd. So brand yourself is the first to be sure there is a substance in your image. Yeah? So you need to Colgate has to deliver what it says, right? So kya aapke toothpaste mein namak hai, yeah, kind of stuff. Yeah. So they have namak in the toothpaste and it does the cleaning job for you. Education, training, experience, integrity in ethnicity, yeah. Know thyself, what is your vision of the world and what is your purpose? What are your values, passion? What are your top goals and what are your attributes? So if you are able to answer these questions, yeah, you will be able to identify saying that who you are and what you do. So how do you analyze your brand? So do you have a positive awareness about yourself? Do you have any association with your quality and efforts you work? Do they have trust in you? Yeah. So when you talk about Tatas, what does they talk about? Yeah. So when somebody will in an interview will call you and say that, tell me, what do you, your professor will call you as your brand? Or what your colleagues or your peers or friends in your classroom would call you. So will you have an answer to it, saying that what is your brand? Have you thought through about it? Yeah. So these are the questions which you need to answer about your own brand. So there are few techniques which really will help you to understand. You're a management graduates now, almost towards it. So you know what SWOT analysis is all about. How define yourself in three objectives, saying that what are those objectives, saying that do you call yourself intelligent, hardworking, go-getter, cooperative? What are those things which will differentiate yourself? So these are few samples which are given: energetic, intelligent, enthusiastic, trustworthy, persistent. Who you are primarily. You were an animal. What animal would like to be? So what are the traits you're bringing? So I would call myself as a horse. Yeah. So horse is a family loving this thing with a lot of horsepower. Yeah. Lambi race ka ghoda. That's what I am. I call myself. So who you are. Define what you stand for, what are your values. Yeah. Is there any heritage to back you up, a trajectory of achievement, saying that have you worked with a social cause, have you really helped your friends to come up with somebody who was going through a tough time, you are able to help them. Yeah, some unique thing which you were able to achieve. Yeah, so I was talking to students while I was having a breakfast out there. So what is the 2 months of internship project you have done? Those 2 months industry exposure, yeah, 60 days of time, what did you do there? And if you've done a genuine work, people don't want, in 2 months you can't achieve so much, yeah? But whatever you've done, have you done genuine efforts? If you have taken that questionnaire, have you understood the genesis of questionnaire, how it has been drafted? Did you really go and talk to people, take down those? Did you do a data analysis? What were the trends coming up? What is your pattern coming through? What are the suggestions you are going to make it to? You need to be thorough when you are administering that questionnaire. If you have not done that, interviewer will be able to see through it. Yeah. So those 2 months and training period is very critical of it. Your value proposition. So the question I would ask, saying that simple question I'm asking, saying that how do you feel when people are with you? So do they feel enthusiastic, inspired, motivated? Yeah. So the interviewer is looking for people who would make this kind of a statement, saying that when I am with people, they feel motivated. They said that we can achieve unimaginable. So that talks about my leadership quality and influencing power. Do I feel positive, excited, happy? Do others feel a stronger self-concept when they are associated with you? Do they feel adventurous, sophisticated, successful? How do you make people feel around you? Is the question you need to address to. I'm just introducing this concept to you. This is a full-fledged workshop which I would conduct primarily. Maybe some other time I would come to your college and have this one. But I can pass on the material which you can self-work and do that. So let's say, assume that you are in this college. And which floor do you typically conduct interviews, campus interviews? Let's say the interviews are happening in this is on third floor, right? And there is a CEO of Microsoft. Yeah, Sundar Pichai, who comes to your college, yeah, and you're late and you're just running towards the elevator, and you see Sundar in this thing, you hesitate. He said, "Come in." So you and Sundar in the lift, and third floor has been pushed, and Sundar asks you, saying that, "What do you do? So what's your elevator pitch?" Here is those 30 seconds where you could tell him, saying that this is what you do. Yeah, that's the first point of contact with CEO of Microsoft, where you had an opportunity to sell yourself. What's your 30 seconds elevator pitch? Can you sell? Are you ready? Anybody? Can anybody make an attempt at least? Somebody said yes. Yeah. So what's your elevator pitch? Who you are, what you do, one thing that you love to do. Yeah. Who do you do it for? And what do they want and need? How do they change and or transform as a result? Do you have an internet connection here? Can you just check with this guy? So I would say that, if I met Sundar, say that I help organization to be successful in the marketplace. Yeah. somebody would say that I help children to have sweet dreams and good sleep. Maybe professor of your college would, if he's there, saying that he would say that I anticipate Microsoft needs and I deliver those products, service to people who would make Microsoft successful. Yeah. So suddenly he would say that the next question is it you really help people to be successful and achieve their dreams? How do you do that? Yeah. By the time we are on the third floor already, he would say that, boss, let's meet up for a coffee. I'll tell you how we do that. Yeah, so we have already generated an interest in an individual and would say that, hey, I want to know what is that you're more doing which other institutes are not doing. How are you helping people to achieve their dreams? Yeah. So this is very critical, and it will only come, that 30-second will come when you'll spend maybe 30 hours of your own work. The second thing, once you identify what you want to do, yeah, and what really excites you, the very important, the other thing would differentiate you is your attitude. Yeah, what's here? How strongly or how desperately you want to succeed? How many of you are here because your parents have sent you here? Because your parents said that, yes, I want my son or daughter want to be an MBA. Yeah. How many of us we are here like this? All of us. Nobody is saying that I am not. Now, I have now that you know we understand what the brand is all about, you know, who am I, what I do, and the concept of self-brand, and you know how I'm going to differentiate amongst the lakhs of students. Yeah. What really is going to be a differentiator is Arunima Sinha in you, saying that how desperately you want to succeed in life. Yeah. And I'm playing it's a longish video, but it's a story about Arunima Sinha. Yeah, the next slide. She was part of the basketball team. Yeah. You able to read? Okay. Yeah. She was a part of the sports team. Yeah. She was traveling by train. And there were a few people came in and there was some tussle fight which gone through, and she was thrown out of running train. And by the time she got into hospital, yeah, the kind of condition she was into, her legs required to amputate. So she had a choice to make, saying that, you know, how I'm going to survive and do what is life, and a sportsman who is looking forward to make a career, what is that next? Yeah. It's a story of Arunima, and my urge to you all is look within and try and understand and find out what is that Arunima within you wants to be. So there is Arunima in all of us. Yeah. So we need to listen to our own heart and mind. But that's what you're saying, that what's your passion and what's the difference we want to make in individual life and others. So I'll leave you with this thought on saying that what is my personal brand? So what is Arunima's personal brand? Yeah, she is a fighter. Yeah, she is demonstrated with her behavior, saying that whatever the adversities comes, yeah, if I decide, I'm going to achieve it. Yeah, so resilience. Yeah, passion. And ready to work hard and go that extra mile to achieve and make nation pride. So these are the few things. So what is my personal brand? who am I? And what is that I want to achieve? So we had two fantastic, two different videos which we watched. One is, you know, about what is my life purpose, and the second one is Arunima. Yeah? So who's your real life hero? Figure out who you really want to follow, what is that you want to achieve. And if we are able to answer these questions, you don't need people like me coming here and telling about what does industry wants. Isn't it right? I'm nobody to tell you. Because you already know what you want. Yeah? So all the best for your upcoming event, for the placements. Yeah? But largely, I would say that, you know, ponder over, you know, take this home, think through. This is not going to help you only for your placements, but probably the life as well. Yeah. So thank you so much for being, you know, inviting me.
The house is open for questions.
Sir, according to you, what is the most important competency that you see in a fresher when he enters the corporate world?
So there are two things which I'll say which will differentiate competencies, or, you know, what is that I will say is, one is the ambition, and the other one is the grit. Grit in the sense how desperately you really want to, you know, succeed in life. Yeah? But of course you would, you've done your 2 years training and you have certain amount of theoretical concepts with you. Yeah. But primarily, whenever the interviewer comes in for a campus placement like this, they would look for candidate to demonstrate something. What is the ambition? What is the overall, you know, picture of life he wants to achieve? Does he really wants to, he's looking at the, you know, specific that job role which is in that. So that becomes a milestone in between. Yeah. So the way Arunima is saying that, you know, from a base camp. So you go from a base camp to a 3,000, 3,000 to 6,000. So what is that ultimately you want to achieve? And if you have that kind of a concept, you may not have clarity. But if you at least have a concept in your mind saying that this is what I want to do. Yeah. So what is my ambition? Another one is saying that am I ready to, you know, work hard for it? So that extra efforts which I'm going to ready to put in, saying that there is a belly in my fire in my belly. Yeah. So how desperately I want to succeed. And these are two things which will an individual would look at. Yeah, am I able to answer you? Because there are so many people will come here and they'll talk corporate language with you. Yeah. But I have worked in a corporate for around 18, 20 years. And now I have, last 3 years, I'm into my own journey, which I'm looking at. So whenever I'm looking for professionals who are coming in. Yeah. So what are the personality traits? These are the personality traits which an individual entrepreneur or a CEO would look at. But of course, integrity, yeah, your communication skills, your ability to sell, how organized you are, your computer skills, these are all given. You need to have those. I remember I hired a girl, she was from a small town from Kolkata. Okay. She did her graduation, post-graduation in HR, and she worked in Kolkata for some time and then came to Pune. Yeah. And both parents were they stayed near that village, and this lady came in. And the only reason I have hired her in Deloitte is because she said that I want to make a career. I want to make a career in HR. Yeah. I would stay away from my parents. Yeah. I have worked in different places, different small jobs I have done. But I am now looking forward for a bigger career, and I'm ready to work hard for that. So that's the reason. And she, today she is leading taxation practice for HR in PwC. Yeah. So this is the attitude which makes a difference. Another example I'll give you, there is this a young lady we hired as a trainee. She was ITI in merchandising. She had a tough time when she joined in. People bullied her, she cried. One day she came and said, I can't handle it more. So I said, if you're ready to work along, and you know, I will help you. Now she, today, she is most respected professional merchandiser in my Rewanta lifestyle. Youngest person. She made mistakes, but stayed there and said that I want to make a difference. So that commitment to self needs to be demonstrated. Yeah? Authenticity is very important, boss. You can't be fake. That authenticity has to come. And it's a character. And it will, when you will talk to people, when you will behave, it will, people will be able to judge you on that. You can't fake it. So what we need to do is build a character, then building skills. That's what I would say. And it, that will take you a long way. Because computers, Excel sheet, Microsoft PowerPoint, you can learn. There are training programs. But nobody will teach you that resilience, which Arunima is talking about.
I, Tarun Singh, feel honored and privileged to get an opportunity to thank sir for enlightening us. On behalf of Sri Balaji Society, I express my profound gratitude to our guest, Mr. Sandip Pable sir, for sparing his valuable time to guide us for a successful career. We are greatly encouraged by your gracious presence and immensely benefited by your address.